This video will take you through how to use Google Forms as a way to stay connected with students. The first thing you will want to do will be to create a new Google Form. How you do that is by clicking on your Google Apps within your portal and opening Forms. Or another way is if you're in a new window, just to type in forms.new, and that will take you to a new form. When I open it up, I'll want to title my form. This one will be used as a daily check-in with students. Then I'll add a bit of a description. From there, I can start adding in questions right away. So a few options. When I click on the title of the question, I then have a drop-down menu. So when I do a form, I always like to start with name. So I would choose the short answer and then just add in my question, which would be first and last name. I'm going to turn required on. That will force them to answer this question before they are allowed to be done with the quiz. Now that that's done, I can go ahead and add in a new question. This one I'm going to make multiple choice. And you see I already have an option here. I just need to click on that title to change it. I can also use images for answers, so I can Google search click on the image I want and press insert. Then I can add in my second option. And I can continue down the list, giving a few different choices. If I want this required, again, I can turn that on. When I'm ready to add another question, I just push the add button. Question number three might be, were you able to locate your assignment today? Typing in again, it gives you suggestions. So you could just click yes. You could add another one, which is no. I could click maybe, and then actually I could just type on it and say, I could also again add images here, making it adaptable to different age groups or different learning levels. And again, adding a new question. This question here, I might want to make a short answer and ask them something a bit more specific. Okay, I might make that one required and continuing on from there. You can see over here at the top, I can customize the theme. So I can choose a theme here. There's lots of different options. You can even upload your own picture if you want as well. Once I've chosen a theme, then I'll get some color options to go with that theme. That just changes the background a bit. And then I can also change my font style. When I think I'm ready and this looks good to me, I can choose where I want to save it in my drive. And all I need to do is exit out. It's automatically saved. I don't need to worry about it. Now I go to my classroom and I can make a post. I press add and I go to my Google Drive. Here I can see my form. And when I'm ready, I can post it. Now you have two ways of getting back into that form. You can simply click it here and press the edit button. And this will allow you to see responses at the top. Or you could go back into it through your Google Drive, double-clicking it to open it up. Again, responses are on the top. When you click on responses, you can then see a summary of everyone. Or I could look at individuals and go through answers that way. Clicking on the next button to navigate them. Or I could also go through question by question. Clicking on the next answer, or sorry, the next slide to see different questions. If you want, you can generate a sheet. This will give you an Excel look at things. I had already put it in the trash. Normally you wouldn't get that memo. And just, again, exiting out when you're done. If you want to print this, those three dots at the top, you can print all responses or you can download responses. And just exiting out, it is saved in your drive. One thing to keep in mind, if I wanted to use that daily check-in for more than one class, all responses would still generate on the same form. So in order to change it, if I want to be able to check in specifically for different classes, I would have to make a copy in my drive. Over here, the three dots, press make copy, and just change the name, maybe daily check-in, and specify it to what class. Then I can share it with this class instead, and when I go to responses, I'll only have the responses for those students.